Praise the Lord. So this is the final segment, I pray it so, of our today's discussion topic, why you should never mock a man of God. This is the final part, and I hope you've listened to part one and two so you can understand the concluding part. Hallelujah. So I was sharing also a testimony of a family that was inflicted because of something someone did, but God delivered the family because of the children. So I shared that story in the part two, the second segment. So this is the concluding part. Why you should never mock the man of God. There are consequences when you mock a man of God. Even if the man of God was wrong, don't mock him. Pray for him. You can rebuke whatever happened, but don't personalize it to attack his integrity as a servant of God. We are all sinners. I sin daily, and I do not justify myself whenever I sin. So I just want you to understand that I'm not righteous, but I boast proudly in the Lord that I have never consciously sinned. Praise God. So I just want you to know, you shouldn't mock a man of God, no matter what. They fight strongest battle on earth. That you have a platform on social media, don't use it to fight them. We have too many salvation messages to preach from the scriptures. Do not major in your minor fighting a servant of God trying to put the person down. Let God be the righteous judge. Preach the word of God and let him be the righteous judge. So I was telling you about this sister. I met the children when I visited Uganda, and the children, so beautiful family, so wonderful family. They took me as their father, and so wonderful family. So when I was leaving, the Lord asked me not to see the mother, because at that time the woman was in the hospital with the sister who had an accident, and she really wanted to see me. She thought I was going to visit the hospital maybe to pray for them. So I left back to the United States, and we kept in communication with the family. And eventually the woman, I gave my number, she started communicating with me. I still had no message for her. I didn't know why God asked me to connect with the family, but God had already told me, you know, why he brought the children closer is for their mother. But there was nothing for me to do with the mother. So one day the mother's sister was going in for surgery in that hospital, and the woman sent me a message to please pray for the sister. I believe it was a voice note to pray for the sister, and she was going for surgery. And she said, now see how I love African woman, she said, prophesy about the surgery, that it may be successful. When I listened to that message, I was like, she's going in for surgery, what do I have to do? And God said to me, that's an opportunity. She loves prophecies. She loves prophecies. I want to validate your mission in her life. I want to validate for her to know that I sent you in the family. This is what you will tell her. Tell her that the surgery will be successful, but there will be complications, because there will be a blackout. A blackout. While, you know, during this, in the theater, there will be a blackout, like power outage in the theater at the point of concluding the surgery. So that will make this great complication that the surgery will delay, but fear not. That was my message to her. And, you know, it didn't make sense to me. But guess what? The surgery that wasn't supposed to last maybe 2 hours almost took the whole day. The whole day. So when she came out, exactly what I told her was what happened, and she became scared. And she not paid attention to listen to me. And that was when God spoke. God says, okay, now, she has so many things to tell you, and I want to tell you what to tell her. So when she came out of the hospital, the sister was discharged, everything, she became so free and started, she was free to talk to me because she had seen the power of God. I've never met this woman till now. And nobody knew. I mean, she was going in for surgery, and you told her what was going to happen. She didn't, doctors didn't know there would be power outage. It never happened before, but it happened. Surgery was successful, but there was a power outage. We delayed the surgery, so she was shocked. So She started telling me her problems, that somebody is after, believe like witchcraft, all this stuff, you know, Africans who so much believe in witchcraft, you know. So she told me witchcraft, that whenever she sleeps, there's this big python, there's this big snake that comes and does this, revelation of python, revelation of this. I just want to cut it short. I don't want to go into details or nitty-gritty of this story, but I just want to hit at something. I asked her a question about her Christian life. She told me, and how she all started. I said, look, I'm going to pray for you, for this witchcraft, and whoever that bewitched you, and I'll come back, and we will pray together. So as I went to pray, and the Lord said, why do you want to pray? This is why I asked you to come into the family to set her free. This is why I asked you to come into the family to set her free. If you pray from now till next year, next 10 years, this woman will die. Nothing will happen. I said, what happened? He said, okay, good. She was part of a conspiracy against the servant of God. Not a conspiracy. She spoke ill of a man of God, a pastor of her church. Not just the pastor, the pastors. In fact, what made her case worst, that almost was leading her to death, was the pastor's wife she spoke against. Out of anger and congregation of people speaking, and the pastor took you as her own. You see why I told you? I don't like being too close to men of God. Me. I don't like to. If I were you, I don't like to be closer to them. Because when you are too close to them, you will see a lot of errors. A lot of errors. That might make you lose confidence in them. No, that's not how God functions. When Jesus was on earth, he partied. He went to a wedding. He danced. I would have. Jesus danced. Imagine me saying, is this the Messiah dancing? You know, hanging out with women. But that is it. That's the human nature of Jesus. So don't judge a man of God when he tries to be a man or a woman. Don't. So she did that, and the Lord said to me, she wronged this soul man of God, her pastor. Tell her that. And she was about dying. Everything blocked. No promotion at work. Nothing was moving for her. Nothing. Everything blocked. And the man of God didn't know. See why it was so dangerous. The man of God didn't know. She didn't know. He didn't know. The wife didn't know. So they didn't pray against her. They didn't altar against her. The calling of the man fought the woman. Devil is a blackmailer. The Bible calls him the accuser of the brethren. The man didn't know. So the Lord said to me, now, for the fact you have identified with the children, and for the fact I have remembered her, she has cried enough. She has cried enough. See what you will tell her. Let her buy something sweet, something, a drink or something, and take to the man of God. And the man of God, just go give it to the man, and the man will ask you to kneel down and pray. I said, really? Okay. I called the woman. See what you will do. Do you have money? She said, no. So I'm going to send you money. Buy a drink and take some cash. Put it in the envelope. Take it to the man of God, wherever he is. No, break protocol. Hand this gift over to him, and the man will ask you to kneel down for prayer, and the man will break whatever chain that is limiting against you. And the woman said, is that all? I said, yes. I sent her the money, and she went, and she bought it, and she took it to the man. And just as the servant of God said, the man took it, and the man said, kneel down, I want to pray. And the man spoke life into her destiny. The man did it. He spoke life. And guess what? Captivities changed. Captivities taught how I love Jesus. Things began to move. Promotions came. Elevation at work came. The children all traveled. Everything moving for good. And the Lord said, you've done your part. It's time to disengage. Because worst is coming. There are some people, I don't know if they are destined to be stupid, if they are destined to be foolish. And I want to tell you, because I don't know what you're going through. Examine yourself. Who did you wrong? Stop praying and think, who did you wrong? And ask for forgiveness. Seek for that person and ask for forgiveness. Seek for that person and say, please forgive me. I have wronged you. I have wronged you. that will